And what about foreign relations, Professor? Because for the first time, we're seeing a president of the Philippines attending the UN General Assembly in New York, speaking before the other leaders of before the other state leaders. They're touting his trips as being him as a flying salesman of the country. How is he doing in terms of representing the Philippines in the international stage?
Well, that's actually part of the goal of any president who would travel outside the country. Mm-hmm. That is to act as a salesman for the country, and to attract do business deals with investors. I think he's doing quite well, except that the optics are not good, since whenever he would be photographed attending to his duties, for one, there's always certain media outlets would always say that he has visited this country, has met this leader, mm-hmm. alongside with his cousin, with his son.
With his son. Oh.
And that doesn't create a good image on his part. Oh, kasi parang you're bringing back the old tradition called family diplomacy. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Wherein you either send your family member to talk with an important foreign leader, or you are accompanied by your family members in doing your function, in performing.
And a question to that, Professor Coronacion, is who pays for the trip of, for instance, if the son is not even a government official? And the question of who pays for the funding also goes into the Singapore trip recently, which the executive secretary said it's irrelevant to who pays for that particular trip. So in terms of optics, you have Senator Pimentel asking the president to actually be sensitive. And I guess this also goes into the partying issue in Malacanang. How are they handling this so far? Is there room for improvement in terms of how they are dealing with this in terms of PR, from PR perspective?
Well, I suppose that's one of the effects of having, the resignation of the press secretary. But at the same time, even without a press secretary, Malacanang has to do something with it. Mm-hmm. If there are pictures to be taken, I don't think that it's wise to include the family members in the photos. Mm-hmm. Since you're right, it creates a bad optics for the president. And although I think the son occupies a public position, the question there is, is his presence relevant in that particular affair, mm-hmm. or mm-hmm. event? If I remember correctly, his son is a congressman, mm-hmm. But still, that creates a bad impression about the president. So the main question there is, where are they getting the funds, mm-hmm. In order to for these expenses? And it's a sensitive issue, since a lot of our countrymen are going through hardship, economic hardship, and some of them are still recovering from the effects of the bad typhoon, the recent typhoon. So, mm-hmm. if you put all these things together, I think the president, as well as Malacanang, has to be sensitive about public perception. Avoid mm-hmm. any photograph showing extravagance, showing anything that indicates that they are spending public funds.
Mm-hmm. And Professor Coronacion, one more issue before I let you go. The issue of human rights. We heard Secretary Rimulya speaking before the UN Human Rights Council the other night, and he was really saying that under Marcos' presidency, we are going to expect a different law enforcement approach. He's saying President Marcos is employing a deeply human approach, veering away from that of President Duterte. How important is it for the current administration to distinguish itself from the previous administration when it comes to human rights and the drug war?
Well, I think to a certain extent, speaking the truth, because so far there are no reports indicating that there is a sponsor violence. Except, of course, although it's so far, which comes close to human rights or anything mm-hmm. about violence, is the killing of this famous journalist.
Percy Lapid.
It seems that the government has done very little in order to not just address the that particular incident, but also address the perception. I think it's already a reality that we are experiencing an increase in the number of crimes. Mm-hmm. So I think the president is doing good so far when it comes to human rights, and the statement given by DOJ secretary, the DOJ secretary is, I think, close to truth.
Mm-hmm. But on that note, I understand that you have to go. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Professor Dennis Coronacion, the chair of the UST Political Science Department.